Hello, welcome to Biology for You. In this video, we are going to discuss PUC vector. In the series of videos, we have been discussing different processes in genetic engineering. So, in this very video, we are going to have the basic idea of PUC vector. PUC vector is basically a plasmid vector. Here, P stands for the plasmid and UC stands for the University of California in the place in which this PUC vector is made. And this is one of the most advanced plasmid vector, and it is derived from the PBR322. So the difference is, the major difference is that in PBR322 there are many sequences, there are many regions that got deleted, and the size of the plasmid is very small. That is, this is only 2686 base pairs length, and the origin of replication from the PBR322 is manipulated in such a way that it is possessing high copy number in the PUC vector, PUC vector. So here the origin is manipulated to possess high copy number of more than 100. So the copy number of PUC vector is more than 100, and the genes present in the PUC vector are, there are polylinkers and selectable markers and all. So in this PUC vector there is 54 base pairs region inserted, which is considered as the polylinker or multiple cloning site. Here the polylinker means it is having many restriction sites in this region, and this multiple cloning site means we can insert based on this restriction enzyme sites, cleavage sites, we can cut open this plasmid and insert the gene of our interest into this PUC vector. So coming to the selectable marker present in the PUC vector, the major selectable marker in the PUC vector is beta galactosidase coding LACH gene. So this LACH gene code for the enzyme called beta galactosidase. So this is the selectable marker, and it gives the visual identification of the transformed cells and non-transformed cells. So here gene of our interest is inserted into beta galactosidase producing LACH shed gene, so that eventually the transformed cells are selected. So that is the selection criteria. It is popularly known as blue-white screening. And there are other genes like amphicillin resistant genes and all. So this is the basic characters of the PBR322. Here let us discuss detailed note of the how PUC vector is used in the cloning purposes. That means how do we insert this target gene into PUC vector, followed by how do we select these transformed cells. So for that, if we have a target gene and we have PUC vector, and in the PUC vector there is a LACH gene which code for the beta galactosidase enzyme, as we already discussed. So we need to cut the target gene with the same restriction enzyme that have the site on this PUC vector. So there are many restriction enzyme recognition sites on the PUC vector, so we need to use one of such restriction enzyme for the cutting of the target DNA as well as the PUC vector, so that the same type of cleavage products will obtain, which can be easily fused together. So in the LACH gene, Here we are going to cut the PUC vector to form ends like this, similar ends with that of target gene, so that target gene will go and insert into this latched gene. And if this recombinant vector, this is now called as recombinant vector. So here this recombinant vectors obtained in this gene insertion process are used for the transformation of the media containing bacterial cells. So here the container having the bacterial cell culture, so are transformed this recombinant vector. So there are many cases, there are many possibilities. The bacteria, some of the bacteria able to take up this vector, some of the bacteria is not able to take up this vector, and some of the bacteria will able to take up this vector, but the vector is not having the, may not have this target DNA always. So here when the vectors are cut with this restriction enzymes, without taking this target DNA portion, they may self ligate to form normal vector without recombination in it. So there are three kinds of possibilities: transformed cells with target DNA, transformed cells without target DNA, non-transformed cells which don't have the vector at all. So among these three categories, we need to select the transformed cells with this target DNA insert in them. So for that, if this is non-transformed cells, as we already discussed, there is other amphicillin resistant gene. So these non-transformed cells don't have the vector. That means they don't have the ability to fight with this amphicillin antibiotic. So they eventually die. So this criteria is eliminated totally. So among the culture having live cells, once after these transformed cells are placed, once after this transformation event is carried, we are going for the plating of the transformed cells on the agar plate. So if you inoculate the transformed cells on the agar plate, here in the agar plates, the selection will be carried. So if agar plate having number of colonies like that, as we already discussed, the amphicillin resistant gene will look after these non-transformed cells. So it will eliminate the criteria of the non-transformed cells present in this culture medium. So here there are two kinds of possibilities: transformed cells with target DNA, without target DNA. So here we are going to add the colorless substance called X-gal. So this is the colorless substance. If the beta galactosidase so this is the enzyme coded by lac gene. So this lac gene produces this beta galactosidase enzyme. So if the lac gene is functional, it produces beta galactosidase enzyme and it turns the X-gal, which is colorless substance, into blue color. So if the gene of our interest is inserted into lac-chert gene, the beta galactosidase will not be functional. It is inactivated and it cannot convert this X-gal into blue color substance. So the transformed cells with the target DNA will be remain in the white color, but the transformed cells without target DNA will be having the character of functional lacquered gene, followed by they produce beta galactosidase enzyme which can convert this X-gal present in the media. So when the media is supplemented with this X-gal, these non-transformed cells or the transformed cells without this target DNA are able to produce white color. So if the colony, if the plate, agar plate is having similar white and blue colonies, then we need to select the white colonies which are unable to convert this X-gal into the blue color substance, because of the presence of target DNA in the lacquered chain, which made it non-functional to convert this X-gal into blue color substance. So here we need to select the white colonies and we need to leave the blue colonies behind. So this is what white and blue screening is. So like this, we need to select the transformed cells containing PUC vector. Transformed cells containing PUC vector in which the target DNA is present. So here these colonies are selected and that are used for the further culture and to produce genetically modified bacteria.